Hello, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor. Thanks for joining me today. And I'm talking about the health benefits of zinc. So thanks for joining. Be sure to click subscribe and turn on your notifications so you always get my newest and latest uploads. Leave your questions and comments below. I would love to hear from you. And watch right to the end of the video. Give me that big thumbs up as well if you are learning something new and you love the information that I'm sharing with you. So what are the health benefits of zinc? Well, we know certainly in the news lately that helping our immune system is of utmost importance. And what zinc does is actually works on two stages of our immune system, being both the humoral, so the antibody antigen aspect of our immune system, but also the T cell immunity and the cell mediated part of a branch of the immune system. So it's unique in that it's working on both facets, which is so important when we're looking at keeping our immune system strong, especially in the event of a cold or flu virus that's coming our way. As well as it helps to decrease inflammation. And we know that the inflammatory response definitely is not something that we want happening in our body, especially as we age. In terms of longevity, we want to make sure that we're keeping that overall inflammation down in the body and doing it, you know, in a natural way, by making sure we're covering all our bases in terms of our vitamins and our mineral status. And of course, zinc being a very important mineral in the body, it's so important that we're able to do that and, you know, to know that that correlation is there. So if you've got a lot of inflammation, maybe it's in the joints, maybe it's an inflammatory condition in the gut, then you really have to make sure that you're checking your zinc status. And the unfortunate thing, which I've shared in another video, is that it's hard to test for a zinc deficiency. So in terms of regular blood work, so you may have to do some more investigation there and cover those bases. So make sure you're getting enough in the diet. And if not, then you may need to supplement. Now, zinc also helps with men's health. So it really helps in the testosterone production, but also helps to decrease something called DHT, so dihydrotestosterone, which is the not so favorable type of testosterone, which causes andropause symptoms. So like the men's menopause. Yes, the guys do go through their struggles as well, ladies, and we have to support them. So maybe it's helping them with their zinc status and their zinc levels is an important thing that, you know, guys have to be on top of this. And it's when that DHT gets out of hand, this is when they lose their hair, they deposit fat in all the wrong places, and guys don't like that so much, and it affects the libido and their, you know, virility as well. So really important that we are able to supplement zinc in natural and healthy ways. Another thing that zinc does is it helps with carb metabolism. So if you love carbohydrates, you love your sweets, you love all of those, you know, things that we shouldn't be consuming too much of, zinc has a lot to do with our insulin production. So when we don't have enough zinc, then we could be compromised. And this is where we can get into insulin resistance. And, you know, the whole addictive quality of carbohydrates is a big problem. So be sure to check out my whole episode on sugar addiction. Really interesting information there. And it really makes you sort of clue in and evaluate yourself as to, you know, is it an actual addiction thing that's happening with sugar? And in that video, we talk about different ways that you can actually help yourself, which is, you know, it's a game changer in terms of if you love sweets and you're hooked on sweets, it really is important to try to abstain as much as possible. And yeah, you can have a little treat once in a while, but overdoing is certainly not in your best interest. Now, zinc also helps with our vision. So in terms of our eye health and in terms of the physiology here, what happens is that zinc helps to transport vitamin A to the retina, which is at the back of the eye. And that's important for proper vision. That's important for night vision as well, for us to be able to see clearly. And without zinc, then we can have that compromised vision. And there's definitely a correlation with zinc status and macular degeneration. So getting the right amount of zinc is important, because with macular degeneration, what we do is we lose that central focus. So if I'm looking at, you know, I'm out in the woods and I'm looking, whatever I'm looking directly at, I would lose that focus and I would be able to see clearly around that area, but what I'm directly focusing on would not be clear. So that would be an indication of the macular degeneration and something to definitely consider the zinc deficiency as being one of those things that you have to cover that base. Now, zinc also helps with our insulin production. So for diabetics, this is super, super important, but also with wound healing. So zinc is very reparative to the skin. And we know with diabetes that you're certainly at higher risk for developing wounds, and especially in the feet. So you have to be super careful. So in the combination of zinc with magnesium and vitamin K2, that correlation is there to help with the absorption of zinc, but to really help to protect the skin, and also to make sure that if there is a wound that happens or trauma to the skin, that it will heal up more quickly. And this is especially true for diabetics because it helps with the insulin as well. Zinc also helps with other skin conditions. So whether that's the acne, so chronic acne, it could be related definitely to a zinc deficiency. And it's amazing when you start taking zinc, getting more of it in the diet or taking a zinc supplement, how the acne actually improves, as well as rashes. So the eczema, the psoriasis, these would be, again, related to that zinc deficiency. So these rashes can dramatically improve when you have the right amount of zinc in your body. And also bleeding gums. So that would be an indication, yes, of a vitamin C deficiency, but also a zinc deficiency. So it's important, again, to make sure that you're getting enough zinc. Another thing would be muscular pain. So a lot of aches and pains in the body could be related to a zinc deficiency. And this has to do with the protein synthesis in the body. And zinc is reliant on helping us to make our proteins. But we know that proteins are required for muscle formation. And most of the zinc in our body actually sits in our muscles. And that's really important, especially as we age. There's something called sarcopenia, which I've talked about in other videos. And that's the relative loss of muscle mass with the aging process. And it's something that we definitely want to stave off. We do not want to be in that situation of muscle mass. We have to maintain our healthy muscles. That's what keeps us upright, able to be energetic and go, you know, and do our exercise and all the things that keep us young and healthy. So zinc has a lot to do with this, and it's so important that we have enough zinc in our body every day. Another thing is viral infection. So certainly top of mind, absolutely. So whether it's with colds and flus, zinc helps with a fever as well. And because remember, it's working on both branches of the immune system. So that's really important, but also helps with swelling of the mucous membranes. So if you've got a runny nose and a sore throat, or maybe your lungs are acting up and you have a cough, then the zinc can be really helpful. Yes, for the immune system, absolutely, but also for the actual symptomatic relief of being able to take it for those conditions, because it helps to soothe those mucous membranes. So thanks for watching today. I hope that you learned something new and all about zinc, which is so interesting to me, especially this, you know, what we've gone through in our lives in the past few months. It's so important that we educate ourselves about these wonderful things that we can do naturally. And certainly if you have a zinc deficiency, then that could be something that you can definitely solve by making sure that you get enough zinc. So check out our other video on how and the best sources of zinc and how to implement that into your daily routine. Please give me a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button so that you always get our newest and latest uploads. And also click the bell, turn on those notifications so you're notified when we upload something new. I'll see you next time. Remember to always take care of your good health and do it naturally.